What I want to talk about with a quick initial perspective with Avinash Gorakhshekar is what could happen to NBFCs today, considering that there's such a big rally on Friday in banks and NBFCs, and we haven't seen a stimulus package of any sorts come out thus far. Avinash, tactically, would you reckon that because the world markets are also starting soft today or not going up, and there is no stimulus package that has been announced as yet, and there was such a big move on Friday, that we might see a pullback in NBFCs today?
Good morning, Neeraj. I think NBFCs, which saw a good bounce on Friday, I would believe that the markets are keenly waiting for some sort of financial package. And today we could see a little bit of softness, considering the fact that today we could be starting a little softer in the initial session. But overall, I would believe that private sector banks still continue to be better positioned than NBFCs. And even if the NBFC package does come in, you're going to see the larger NBFCs, like Bajaj Finance, could possibly gain significantly. The smaller ones, who are largely on the housing finance side or maybe the loan against property side, and which currently dominate largely the business mix, I think there could be a lot of pain at least for the next 2 to 3 quarters. So I think today we could see a little bit of softening, but I think the larger players like Bajaj Finance could possibly consolidate.
What about IT, Avinash? That space is in quite a focus today or the last few days as well, and after the numbers from TCS and the commentary thereof, and we have the big Infy result coming out later today.
No, I think broadly, I think market has discounted that, the coming 2 to 3 quarters could definitely be a lot challenging for most of the IT majors. In fact, in TCS commentary also, the tone of the management was pretty cautious. And I think Infosys also, rather than the numbers, the markets would be keenly looking at what kind of guidance and what kind of demand outlook the management actually comments post these Q4 numbers. Because clearly the first half of FY21, Neeraj, is going to be extremely challenging. And what kind of client wins and what kind of impact it has on the BFSI segment, which is a key segment for Infosys as well as the entire IT sector, is now going to be in question. So I think management commentary on all these related issues could be very important. And I think the stock is not going to go rise in a hurry. I think you would possibly see a lot of bumps on the way. So I think it's better to hold on. I would not recommend anybody to buy fresh at this point of time.
But Avinash, a quick word from you on either of the two. L&T, slight silver lining with the orders, and Tata Motors with an extremely disappointing retail sales for JLR.
No, I think, Devina, as far as Tata Motors is concerned, I think we continue to be negative. And I think, despite the fact that the stock has been beaten down badly and may not see a major correction from current levels, I think the financials are going to be extremely weak, and cash flows, as I mentioned earlier, are going to be under complete strain. I would not be surprised that the company may announce a cutback in their capex plans, at least in the coming financial year, to conserve cash. And therefore, I think it's completely avoidable at this point of stage. As far as L&T is concerned, the news flow definitely is positive, but I think execution is now going to be the key factor which the markets are going to watch. With this lockdown, if it gets extended, it could obviously hamper the execution. So I would believe that, yes, there is a silver lining, but I think it's yet too early days to assume that capex cycle as well as these execution of these projects are going to be easy. So I think it's better to wait and wait for some more time. Would prefer to buy this stock on a decline rather than at the current price.
I just want to focus on the Adani Group stocks as well, because over the weekend, most of the companies saw a reduction in pledge. Or release of pledge. So you had Adani Transmission, where pledge shares were released along with that. Pledge shares of Adani Enterprises, Adani Ports. Do you feel that this group as a whole now, Avinash, is something which is any which way has been in the limelight pre-COVID? You had seen some sharp moves coming across the board. Do you feel you want to stick to this group in any shape and form?
I think, Devina, the pledging share issue is one factor. The other factor is most of these Adani Group companies have significant, debt on the balance sheets. And I think this is one factor which is going to be extremely negative, at least in the near term. at least as of now, I would not be, very keen to put my money here, considering the fact that, fixed costs as a percentage of their total expenditure is pretty high. So I think, these companies do have a reasonable amount of cash on the books, but considering the amount of debt they have, especially Adani Enterprises, Adani Ports, I would believe that, it's better to stay away. I would believe that the only exception could be Adani Gas, where, they operate in the city gas distribution network. And from a longer term perspective, any decline here could be a good opportunity.
Avinash, quick 30 second view. We're very close to market open. Chola, did you look at the business update? What would you do here?
No, I think, Niraj, in the near term, I think the stock could come under a little amount of pressure, considering that the CV cycle continues to be extremely weak. And with the loan moratorium given, I think the markets could possibly be not looking at quarter four numbers, but the first quarter and the second quarter of FY21, because a lot of asset quality, I think, issues could crop up. So I think it's better to wait for some more time. The company has solid business fundamentals, but I think in the near term, there are a lot of headwinds and challenges for this.
Avinash, did you get a chance to look at that Westlife update? Of course, there was pressure on quarter four. The same store sales growth declined. But they spoke about how they're reducing the plans to open stores. And they gave us a sense of the liquidity situation within the company, which didn't seem all that bad.
No, I think clearly the business update which has been put out by the company, Niraj, looks a bit cautious. And I think quarter four is definitely going to be a period where you could see a little amount of stress both on the top line as well as on the margins. But going forward, I would believe, if they do reduce the capex for opening new outlets, that is obviously going to impact their future top line growth. And I think the markets would obviously be looking at when full-fledged normalcy actually begins. I think one would have to wait for at least one or two quarters before normalcy actually starts off in a big way. Despite the fact the company making claims that, they have contactless delivery channels, I would believe that, the first half of FY21 is also going to be a little under stress, and there could be a little bit of margin pain. So I think it's better to hold on. Fresh buying could come in possibly from our side only at lower level. So I wouldn't be surprised if the earnings recovery in FY21 could get a little, stopped at least for the time being.
HDFC Bank. The other business I want to focus on is on the AMC business. And Avinash, I want to come to you on this one. Now, March, when we saw the SIP figures coming out, they did hit a fresh 12-month high, I think 8,641 crores. But the other aspect is the SIP stoppage ratio, which came in at 71% and crossed the previous high of 66% that it hit in September 2019. Now, this obviously indicating that the number of SIPs discontinued or expired as a percentage of fresh registered SIPs is on the higher end. What does it do for the AMC businesses? I mean, the likes of HDFC, AMC, and Nippon, Motilal Oswal, how do you think this will play out?
I think my guess is, Devina, in the next 3 to 6 months, you are going to see a lot of stress on inflows for most of the larger AMCs. And I think the very fact that SIP cancellations have been around 65 to 70 odd percent clearly shows that incremental SIP flows are now going to be impacted at least for the next one or two quarters. Longer term, I think these numbers would get corrected. But in the near term, these challenges would continue, considering the fact that the markets are going to be volatile and there's definitely a lot of stress on liquidity by these investors. So short-term retail investors obviously would book out. But yes, in terms of the incremental upside for these companies, there could be a little bit of sluggishness in most of the AMC companies like a Nippon or a HDFC AMC, which, in the near term, at least are going to be underperformers. I think within the cement pack, I would believe that, companies like UltraTech, Ramco Cement typically could definitely do better. And I think, smaller players like JK Cements, I think markets would be definitely be happy that, most of these players are now restarting their plants. So incrementally, I think possibly the June quarter and the September quarter could possibly now see a kind of resumption of normalcy. But yes, for markets to actually re-rate these stocks, it would take a long time because infrastructure, pockets have definitely been impacted significantly. And I think as far as execution goes, I think, as long as there is sluggishness in infrastructure, these stocks would definitely not fly immediately. But yes, definitely these stocks are good to buy on every decline.
All right. Avinash, I just want to quickly come to you. A sense that we're gathering now from most of our market conversations is that you can start looking at banks, aside from an HDFC bank in the private banking space, Axis Bank fits that bill, ICICI Bank fits that bill. Do you feel that it's time to look at some of these banks instead of just focusing on HDFC?
Yeah, I think clearly, Devina, the second and the third best banks could obviously also be in focus. And I think ICICI Bank and Axis Bank also definitely seem to be well capitalized. And to a large extent, you know, they would also be, providing a little more, for the COVID-19 incremental damage. But I would believe that somebody who's having a slightly medium to long term view could possibly look at Axis Bank and ICICI Bank, considering that, you know, the kind of diversified streams of business and the kind of provisioning which they have and the kind of capacity to withstand shocks further, make them good investment bets, provided, investors are willing to take a long term call. In the short term, there could be challenges, but definitely longer term, these banks could do well.
Okay. So watch out for some of these, not the top ranking bank, but maybe the second and the third bank and ranking banks as well, which are well capitalized. From you, Avinash, are you watching out closely for any of these oil and gas stocks, considering what crude oil is doing? It's at a 21-year low.
I think it could obviously, benefit oil marketing companies and, even players like Reliance. I would believe that oil marketing companies, like HPCL and BPCL could definitely be looking at lower incremental raw material prices, if these kind of crude prices continue to remain, below $20 odd.
Okay.